Welcome back to the show, guys. It's time for Cooking with Can. So today we're gonna make escabeche fish, a very popular dish in the West Indies and very easy to make. But of course, for time's sake, I'm going to make the escabeche because that's the most important part of it. That's the meat of the dish, where I already fried the fish and I'm going to show you. It's so easy, don't worry. I won't make it too hot. But here today to join me, to help me cook is none other than the James Young from The Lowdown.
Okay, all right. I'm here, everybody. That's it.
we might as well just dance.
That's it. That's all we need. That's it. I got magnesium. All right.
I don't know if we're ready to see magnesium yet.
Yeah, okay, yet. Gotcha.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me. I'm a fan of what you do.
Okay.
Every week I watch you and you cook all this good food, so I'm feeling really good that I get to be a part of it today.
I love it. Okay, so we're gonna make escabeche fish.
I can't wait.
Escabeche fish is simple. You just need snapper. A lot of people can, you can actually, if you don't have snapper, you can use a fillet.
Okay.
I use swally, which is a very meaty fish.
Okay.
So it has a lot of flavor, it's sweet. But the best part of escabeche fish is making the seasoning.
Is that,
So you have to take out the hot pot. Woo!
Danique, the last time I saw a woman move like that, she was pregnant.
Oh. No. The way the tubes is... The way the tubes is set up.
You ain't doing that.
So okay. Your job is you're going to put the onions in.
Okay, I got
because
you.
Because what we have in the pot already is oil.
All right.
Okay? So you see how that is just nice and sizzled up?
Okay.
So you have your oil ready. And you're going to put your carrots. So you need fresh carrots. Now, when you make this at home, you're using the same oil that you cook the fish in.
Okay.
Okay? So you're not going to clean the oil. You're not going to change it. You're using the same exact
thing. It absorbs those flavors.
Exactly. And you let that cook. So we're going to put it back on because it cooks very quickly.
Okay. It smells good already.
Give it a little bit more.
Okay.
But you have to, you know... You have to have some hips with it.
Hips, okay.
When you put it in.
All right.
When you put it in.
Gotcha.
Okay, so this is your job. Let's get to cooking.
All right, I got you, girl.
So he's gonna keep on stirring that, stirring it, because what it needs to do, it needs to sit in, and it needs to soak.
Oh, that.
You smell that?
Smell good already. Smell that?
So in that, all you need is a little bit of seasoning. So you need your salt, you need your pepper, you need your brown sugar, you need your oregano, and thyme.
Okay.
Now, the secret of this is this. This mason jar.
What is that?
I'm just going to put a little bit of magic in there.
Okay.
This mason jar is in every single West Indian home. This is really what escabeche is, and this is a true escabeche. Okay? So, this is already prepared. So, it has onions, it has pimento, it has carrots, and it's soaked. We leave it in the fridge.
Okay.
So all of the goodness is in this. Now, if you don't have this, you can make it this way, which is a traditional way as well.
Okay.
Make it while...
You actually cook it.
Exactly.
Got you.
So you keep on stirring. How does that... You smell that?
Man, if you guys were here with me right now, you'd be licking this hot plate. It smells so good.
So... This is Scotch bonnet pepper. So this is what Scotch bonnet pepper looks like, a Jamaican pepper. Smell that.
Woo.
Extremely hot. Woo. I've always said when you use this, do not use the seed, just the pepper.
Okay.
So you start, you, like you big. You should be able to start a little bit heavier.
Okay, got you.
So we're gonna go ahead. So this has the salt already. This has the pepper. This has the oregano. And it has the brown sugar. So I have combined everything just to make it simple. And you sprinkle, sprinkle, sprinkle. And you mix that in. And this is simple. All you're doing is you're letting this sit. You have to use distilled vinegar. Do not try to use apple cider vinegar because it's gonna give it a very different flavor, and distilled vinegar gives it a very that kick.
That what you need.
Okay. Do you cook at home?
Absolutely,
do
I cook.
You cook.
I cook everything. Actually, like, I started out as a chef.
I can tell.
Wow.
No, no, I'm just saying. No, no, no. anything.
I do. I do. Okay. Thank you. All right. Okay. I'll take that. Yeah. Well, my wife, as you know, she's from New York. She's Puerto Rican, so we eat a lot of actual Spanish food. So she actually taught me some real good recipes as far as Latin food. And I grew up in the South, so you know how we cook in the South, girl.
Okay.
We cook two ways.
So we're going to let this simmer down. We're going to let that cook, so I'm going to cover it.
All right.
You're a good stir.
I try to be, man.
You're amazing.
Thank you.
So you're going to take this off of there. So that is the actual finished fish.
Oh, look at that.
And what you're going to do is... We're gonna take, now this is the sauce, it's already prepared.
Okay.
This is what it's gonna look like after, and you put it on top.
Look at that.
You see that? And then you get a little drizzle in there.
Get the juices going.
You get that in there.
Mmm, that looks good.
And I'm gonna put some on this one.
Oh, so I get my own.
Look at, show the people.
Oh, look at this.
Show the people.
Look at this.
That is Escovitch. And where is my co-host? Where is my co-host to try?
Coming to eat some food, baby.
Look at that, babe. Look at that, babe.
Look
at that.
Look, you might as well give him the whole plate.
Yes,
That's how you do it?
Oh.
Chris, that look good, don't it?
Look at the whole plate.
Now, Candace, let me ask a quick question.
Sure.
How did you learn how to cook all these different things? Who taught you to cook,
Roma? My mom.
Miss Roma.
Okay.
Roma.
Shout out to Roma.
My mom. And because I grew up with all boys, I was constantly cooking.
God bless.
I have to taste. Can I taste?
Go.
Okay.
Bruh.
Bruh.
And it's that simple.
That is well seasoned, though.
Through and through.
The fish is not tough. It don't taste bitter. It is perfectly executed, ma'am. It is flaky. It is so seasoned. It is spicy. And you got to kick
it. It's hot. You turn it red.
I'm going to take my shirt off. Okay.
I got me some lunch, baby.
Well, while they finish eating, you got to get out of here. Thank you for tuning in. We'll be back same time.
Same place. Be safe till the next time, y'all.
Bye, y'all.
I'm coming back next week.
Y'all next time.